Here's my confusion about you, because you've been with your wife, Kay, extremely generous in tackling things like AIDS. You've given millions to helping fight AIDS.
Right. So clearly and work with gay organizations all around the world.
Right. So you clearly have no problem with gay people per se, and yet you want to prevent them having the same rights to get married as straight people. And that leads me to, I suppose, a more obvious supplementary question. Do you personally believe that gay people are born gay? Or do they become gay? Are they made gay?
Yeah. You know what? I think the jury's still out on that. It wouldn't bother me if there was, quote, a gay gene found. Because here's what we know about life. I have all kinds of natural feelings in my life. And it doesn't necessarily mean that I should act on every feeling. Sometimes I get angry and I feel like punching a guy in the nose. It doesn't mean I act on it. Sometimes as you pointed out, sometimes I feel attracted to women who are not my wife. I don't act on, just because I have a feeling doesn't make it right. Not everything natural is good for me. Arsenic is natural.
No, but that's why, Rick, that's why I have to jump in again.
Sure.
That is why, though, this is such an interesting debate because, you know, I just believe fundamentally and passionately that gay people are born gay. I don't think you become gay.
And
I think if you were able to convince yourself that they were born gay, you would see it differently. You would see it as a natural condition that people are gay. And then you may change your mind about their rights to have the same fundamental rights as straight people. But if you still believe that they're not born gay but become or get turned gay, then I can see that you can hide behind that as the justification, if you like, for not endorsing same-sex marriage.
I do not believe attraction is a sin, but I do believe that some actions are sin. I'm not responsible for all of my attractions. We know, for instance, that some people are born with natural predispositions towards certain things, either good or bad. Every one of us have those. I'm automatically attracted to certain kinds of art, certain kinds of music, certain kinds. I don't think that's a matter of right or wrong. But the Bible clearly states that I am absolutely in control of my actions. And since I have chosen as my authority for my life, not the government, common culture, anything like that. And by the way, I appreciate the way you're developing this right now, because this is the very kind of discussions that we need to be having, that are sane, that treat everybody with dignity, that treat everybody with love, but could disagree on certain issues and still say, you know what, I don't agree with that guy, but I think he has come to his position from his background or from his...
Okay.